Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. My name is Zidane Hamid and I'm 9 years old. Welcome to our dandy handy show of Cricket with Zidane. And I've thought there's a change in plans, and that is that I think every week I can go with one day in a week cricket around the globe. So today, in this weekend, we're going to talk about cricket around the globe, and today's day is Thursday. So the way it has been cricket in the past few months, it has been totally the madness. And there have been so many matches, and I mean, there have been so many matches, the BBL, the WBBL, the India versus New Zealand, Pakistan versus South Africa, India versus Australia versus Sri Lanka, Australia versus India. So there has been a lot going on in this month, mostly before New Year. After New Year, there has been a lot going in cricket. So let's see what happened first with the match, really good match of India versus New Zealand. So New Zealand already with the series has gone from their hands. The series has gone from their hands. But can they get themselves with eternity and grace? They can win some two matches or prevent themselves from whitewash. Totally accept it because. You see, if there's a team, India is without Kohli, Australia is without Smith, or any other team without their leading players, then it means that they're nothing but mash. And that's why. What did New Zealand did? That Trent Bolt taking 5 wickets, Colin de Grandhomme with 3 wickets, they reduced England to India to just conflicts with cereal and milk. Without Team Kohli, who was really in form, we had Rohit Sharma and Shikhar Dhawan make a 21-run partnership, and then it just fell down. Yeah, first wicket, second wicket, third wicket, fourth wicket, and then Trent Bolt took his 5-4. Very good. And then Colin de Grandhomme also added extra salt and spice with his 3 wickets. And then India were bowled out in an ODI, 92 runs. India Vasumir was the lowest total at that time in 2005, 125. So 92 is a big thing. I mean, getting out for 92 is very bad in ODIs. And since the New Zealanders got a good, very good, jolly good win from just 8 wickets. You see, and that was very easy. And that was 212 balls remaining. That is the most margin of balls. Defeat to India by most margin balls. Previously was by Australia when India was out for 125, and that was like in 2006-5 or something like that. Now, although this match has been a bit late, it has happened on the 26th, the WBBL, Women's Big Bash League, has also come around the game. And this time we had the final, which is pretty much the opposite of the whole Men's Big Bash League. Hobart Hurricanes are first, but right now over here we have Brisbane Heat on first, and that was the final, Brisbane Heat versus Sydney Sixers. Although the Sydney Sixers are really good players, they sputtered and they collapsed to 131 runs and for 8 wickets in 20 overs. Very bad, right? But still, the Brisbane Heat sputtered again, collapsed, really, totally, fell down. But then Warrior Mooney ensured that they can go for 132 for 7 and win. Just one more wicket was remaining, which is that there was 2 wickets to win only to lift the title of the WBBL. Now, if you see in the Big Bash League, to put it up, we see a lot of havoc because we had the Adelaide Strikers and the Hobart Hurricanes. Now, the Hobart Hurricanes couldn't thundered the other team out. And I'm referring to the Brisbane Heat. So they couldn't thunder. They were, very good. They were going for 2 for 126. Matthew Wade again showed his performance with his 85. And then we had Darcy O'Short, couldn't make performance, just 28. And Benjamin McDermott for just only 18 runs. But they were 126 for 2, and then they sputtered and went up in 20 overs, 169 for 7. That is the bad thing. They sputtered. And then after that, the Adelaide Strikers, of course, with a good defending champion, Centurion Jake Weatherald, He scored 82. I mean, he's not been in form. He scored a century in the final previous against the same team. But this time he also went up, spiced it with salt and spice. 82 over here. Not in the final this time. But that pretty much powered them to get a very good and grand 7-wicket win. And there was like at least like 5-4 over remaining. Right? Now, let's go ahead. And now if you see, so far, the BBL has been totally outstanding, amazing, and everything has been going really good. So now, if we see what has happened in the BPL at the P, we will see that the Dhaka Dynamite defeating the Rangpur Riders defeating the Dhaka Dynamites. And that was really good because it was only a 2-run defeat. Oh, that's so sad. The Rangpur Riders went in pretty good. De Villiers, Gale in form, 1,093 for 220 overs. Well, that was mostly from Gale's really good 62. I mean, that's where Gale comes up. Well, if you see Gale batting, he's got a big chunky bat. And when he hits a shot, it doesn't look like he does put a power in it. Because it looks like he's such a powerful man. That one little flick and it's out of the ground. His cover drives are looking like so effortless. Because, I mean, it looks like he's such a strong man and he's just hitting a little like this and then it goes down the ground for four. That is what is Chris Gayle's speciality. And that's what I was talking about. And that's how they powered in for 193 for 220 overs. Of course, we say blistering sixes, blistering fours. And then we have, of course, in the end, the Dhaka Dynamites coming really hard, chasing and trying to go away, trying to get up, and then even though they failed in Bonnie 191 runs. Oh my god, that was so bad. They almost won it, and then that was only a 2-run win. Really great, good performance by the Rangpur Riders. Now you see in the final table after so many matches, we have the Chittagong Vikings removed from number one by those Rebels. Camilla Victorians, they just like put a rebellion against it. And that was where the Chittagong Vikings are just down. I mean, they couldn't make it up. Their performance was pretty much down. And the performance is pretty much down right now. And I hope that they get up again and suck it up and then they come up again and then hit some sixes and fours. Then we have a number three as it's struggling Dhaka Rangpur Riders, which is pretty good. Number two, the Rangpur Riders, very good. They are playing really good. Then we have after that on number three, good performance by the Dhaka Dynamite. Although now they're not going up working, but they're still gonna find their way. And now in the end of the top four, we have Chittagong Vikings who have been losing the two matches and now they're failing into darkness. Now after having a number five, we are struggling to get into the top four, the Rajshahi Kings. They have to do something very quick before the BPL ends because it's gonna be too late, too little and too smart. Then after that, we have, of course, which is, I mean, pretty much it's going down. So if you see the Kolkata Titans is on number 6 and then the Silhouette Sixers going really down. Even if the left-handed David Warner can do anything. So it's pretty much end in the BPL for the Silhouette Sixers. I think it's the end of the road already. So if you see the four matches we have talked about today, those are India versus New Zealand. So that was when 92 runs were all out. And then that's where, of course, New Zealand changed it with no trouble. So let's see what's happened over here. So if you see, Trent Bolt has been in really good form. He's a really good bowler. He's also taken a hat-trick in ODIs against Pakistan. So we know how dangerous this left-arm pace bowler is. So that's when we've seen the magic. Second, King Kohli was not playing. So that meant that it was too down for them. Second, the pitch was really good for the bowler. Good swing was, of course, expected. And then after that, we have that by the time it dried out, the dew factor dried out, it was pretty much smooth sailing for the New Zealanders and wahala for them by the time they got to 92 runs. And it was before they can even see it in 14 overs. Before 15 overs, they chased it. Or you can say in the 15th over. Now the next match we see the WBBL, we can see, of course, nicely that Mooney has made the Brisbane Heat reached that target with a 68. So that's only why the Brisbane Heat won. Otherwise, I'm pretty sure they would have lost because the way they were sputtering. Secondly, and the Sydney Sixers didn't put such a good defendable target. Then after that, if you see in BPL, we see Gale is in really big form. The Universe Boss is again doing some Universe Boss show. A Gale storm is coming. I'm telling you, the Rancor Riders are gonna cruise to the trophy another time, and I'm pretty sure the Comilla Victorians will be the runner-ups. And then we have in the BBL, so Hobart Hurricanes, first of all, their partnership didn't work between Darcy O'Shaughnessy and Matthew Wade. Although Matthew Wade went on to create good runs, but Darcy O'Shaughnessy couldn't work out. That was the problem. And the other batsmen, except with the exception of Benjamin McDermott, couldn't even play. And I mean, Benjamin McDermott was lucky with his 18 runs, but otherwise everybody sputtered. And that was what made the Adelaide Strikers cruise. But then the Adelaide Strikers also get out on low totals. But Jake Weatherall ensured the safety of the Strikers this time. So Jake Weatherall is a good striker. And we have him seeing, everybody needs to see the BBL 2018's final so you can know what happened at that time. That what explains Jake Weatherall in all one sentence. So if we see, this has been going pretty good. And then after that, we also have Pakistan women versus West Indies women. I'm really sad to see that Pakistan women do not compete with other women cricket teams in the world. Maybe it's because the Pakistani women team can't cope up with other teams and they are not so strong in that. Well, if you see, they are always out on their 100 runs and then it's pretty much a mammoth target for them, even if it's 120 or 4. Like I've seen the ICC Women's World Cup and Pakistan were on number 4, just above Ireland, one space above from the last position Ireland. My God, now look at that. That is what I'm talking about, right? There is where I'm just gonna tell you about that in the T20 World Cup. So we know what happened when West Indies scored a very hefty, even though with the loss of 2 wickets very early, a very good 160, which was totally enough to chase. And of course, Pakistan started firing down and all of the 9 batsmen couldn't even get into the double figures. Yeah, now that is where only we can see Bismar Maroof playing 38 runs. That was the only thing which was getting into the double figures. And I don't even know how they managed to get balled out for 89. By that time, I was just thinking that they'll be balled out for under 50 runs because they're such a weak team in T20s. And we didn't have anybody performing anyway. So, if you see again, this has all been really good space, a week of matches. This week number 2 of matches has been really good. That's really nice. And so far, we have just been seeing it, and the World Cup is coming in March. That's really ahead. But we don't know what is the squad of the team right now. But we know that if we see in the Indian team this time, I mean, with the performance against New Zealand, it's pretty much sure that the wicket keeper will be kept as Dinesh Kartik instead of Rishabh Pant. So that is pretty much not something good for those people who are expecting Pant to be a wicket keeper. Everybody was expecting him to be wicket keeping in the ICC ICC ODI World Cup. So then we have the IPL starting early because of the World Cup, IPL 2019. That's also coming. Be sure to not miss out on that. So, and by the way, I thought that there's a chart made for all this. Like the IPL happens in the summer, PSL happens in spring, and the Caribbean happens in autumn. And then we have the Bangladesh Premier League happening in winter. I think that's my chart. And that pretty much, it pretty much makes sense. But though this week of cricket has been totally enjoyable and totally understandable. I just know that this week has been going really good. And since we've seen UAE versus Nepal too in this week, and we had UAE defeating 2-1 Nepal in the ODI series, and that's not something you name about Nepal because they never play test cricket. And then Nepal and UAE's T20 happened, and that was very good with Nepal defeating UAE. That was really good. But for now, this is all of this week. And this is all for today. So if you want to see more videos, go to my website, zidane.com, or even log my Facebook page. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll be waiting for your feedback. Assalamualaikum.